I have a really nice pair of computer speakers. Well, it's not a pair. This is the like the subwoofer power unit, and it's about 15 years old. It's really nice, but it's developed an AC hum. And if you look, it's still an old transformer type power supply, DC supply. So I suspect that the unit has a filtering capacitor that is going bad. So I'm proceeding to take it apart, look what the filtering capacitor is, and replace it. So there you go, that big boy right there that I got my finger on, that is the filtering capacitor. And I've already looked at it, and it is 3,300 microfarads. So I'm going to take this board off, and I'm going to proceed to replace it. I'm going to attempt to replace it with a 10,000 microfarad capacitor. They're both rated at 25 volts. And I'm just double checking here to make sure that that is, in fact, the filtering capacitor in it. And the power leads go to it. So I'm going to remove that capacitor, replace it with the 10,000 microfarad capacitor. But first I'm going to test it, just for my curiosity, with my peak ESR meter. I really love this meter. Tests capacitor ESR to see if it's going bad, a capacitor. But just because it has a great ESR and all doesn't mean it's always doing great, the capacitor. If this has an AC hum, then this capacitor is probably the issue. So I'm going to just look at it. And just as I suspected, it comes a little short of 3,300 microfarads, and the ESR is relatively good for that capacitor. And I'll even double check it on my chart. And the chart does show it's in a good range. So there's my newer capacitor. As you can see, it's a lot bigger because it's three times the capacitance. So that'll really have, that'll filter all that AC ripple, that hum that'll come through. And the capacitor is cheap, probably only cost me a dollar or something like that. So I'm just double checking where the stripe is. And it's towards the outside, so we'll have to mount a new capacitor on it. So I'm going to set the soldering iron to 350 degrees Celsius. I'm just running it a little hotter because the traces are pretty big on it. And I'm just proceeding to heat each of these connections and just slowly wiggling them off gently till the capacitor comes loose. And there it is. A little bit of glue still stuck on. It looks like they glued it for... I'm not going to glue the new one. I don't think it needs it. And I'll just pop this new one in. I got lucky. Didn't have to really clean the traces off. Just going to spread the leads here. Just so it stays in nice and tight. Solder it in. Again, these traces are pretty big, so I'm going to be generous with the solder here. All right, looks good. All right, now I'm going to snip off the leads. I'll clean it up with an alcohol pad. I hate leaving flux residue behind, and that solder does have some flux in it. All right, now it's time to reassemble the whole thing. Test it out. So not all repairs have to be complex. Here's a nice simple repair, and I think the simple repairs that are quick are most rewarding and enjoyable. So now's the moment of truth to see if it works. And it is totally silent, no AC hum. So if you really like this video and you want to see more, please like it and subscribe. Thanks a lot for watching.